In the previous videos, you learned how to create some kinds of questions in ActivePresenter. After that, you can summarize users' performance with a report slide. A report slide allows learners to track and review all their interactions in a course. Today, let's learn how to use report slide in ActivePresenter. The app allows you to insert and customize a report slide with ease. There are some ways to insert a report slide. In the Home or Insert tab, click the drop-down arrow on the New Slide button. Select Report Slide. Alternatively, in the Questions tab, click Report Slide. A report slide contains three parts. The top text box is to add the slide title. The next part has 11 default parameters. The first 10 parameters consist of their specific names on the left and references to the corresponding variables on the right. In details, the first two parameters will display the name and the description, if any, of the project. That information can be set in the Project Properties dialog. Let's take a closer look at the other parameters. The next two parameters inform you of the current date when you take the quiz and the elapsed time in the format hour, minute, second, since the presentation started playing. These two parameters display the number of taken slides and the number of taken interactions. This one lets us know the number of correct interactions in the project. If this parameter shows the total score calculated in points, the next one displays the total score in percentage. The result of the quiz is shown as passed or failed in this one. The final parameter shows the detailed report. Stay tuned to check it in the next part of this video. The last part of the slide is the Review Course button. It allows learners to review the quiz results by the review mode. For more information, refer to the video How to Get Quiz Results Using Report Slide. By default, a report slide contains all the elements mentioned above. However, you can customize any of them to meet your needs. ActivePresenter allows you to add customized parameters, show or hide the default ones, resize the title and default parameters section, and change container layout. To add a customized parameter, click the text area of the text-based object to edit the inline text. Then, click the Home tab, select Reference. In the Variables dialog, select the System tab. Then, select a variable that you would like to add. Change the corresponding name of the newly added one. Note that you can also change the information of the default parameters the way you want. For example, showing scores in a percentage instead of a number. Besides, you are able to show or hide the default parameters easily. To do that, select the Default Parameters section. Then, navigate to the Interactivity tab of the Properties pane. In the Report Display section, untick the parameter boxes that you wish to hide on the report slide, or tick to show them again. After that, you can resize the title and default parameters section by dragging the resizing handles. Alternatively, in the Properties pane, select the Size and Properties tab. The Transform section there offers you the Width and Height combo box to adjust or type the value. Last but not least, you can change the container layout of the parameters section. To do that, access the container layout section in the Size and Properties tab of the Properties pane. It is set as Flex by default. You can switch to another layout as None or Grid if you want. Note that you are able to modify the report slide layout in Slide Master. For more information, refer to the video How to Use Slide Masters. Now, you can customize the look of the slide to match the others. Let's check the output to see how the report slide looks. The default and customized parameters display their general information and overall results. The detailed report shows several parameters. This column displays the index of the slide, which contains the interaction. This one represents the report ID of the interaction. The number of actions that users have tried is shown here. The total score that learners get from graded interactions is displayed in this column, while the next one shows the maximum score learners can get if all graded interactions are correct. This one is a string represented in the output language of the presentation. It can be correct, incorrect, incomplete, or empty. Please check the written tutorials in description for more details. The last one displays the type of interaction represented in the output language of the presentation. That's how to use report slide. Thanks for watching.